In this illustration, we'll analyze another circuit using KCL and KVL. Here we are required to find the current in this 4 ohm resistance in the circuit. If I use KVL, I need to make use of 3 equations and 3 variables in the circuit to get this current. So once again, like other problems, here also KCL will be in the favorable method, for which we first need to distribute the potential. So here I take potential to be 0, on this point potential will be -40 volt. Already told you in previous illustrations that no matter wherever you take 0 potential, if distribution is proper, it won't affect the result. So if here potential is taken as x, on this point potential will be written as x -20. Here I take potential as y, so this will be y+10. Now I need to just calculate the value of x, so that current in 4 ohm resistance is this potential difference upon 4, so this will be x/4. Now to get the value of x, we take KCL equations for different parts of circuit to calculate the value of x. So here we write KCL equation for, KCL equation for the junction where potential is 0. And if I take the sum of outgoing currents from the 0 is 0, then here it can be written as 0 - x/4 plus current going in this direction is 0 - x+20/2 plus in this direction it is -40 - y - 10/2, and this should be equal to 0. Here if we take this 4 as LCM, the result we are getting is -x+, this will be 40 - 2x, and this is -50, so this is -100 - 2y = 0. If we simplify this, this will give us 3x + 2y = -60. See, this is our first equation. We need another equation in x and y to get the value of x. So here we write the KCL equation for y. For the junction at y, we take this current, and this current sum is equals to 0. So current going in this direction is y - x+20/2 plus current going here is y + 10 - x/2 plus current going in this direction is y + 10 + 40/2 = 0. And here directly we can get the equation as 3y - 2x = 50, 60, 70, 80. So this -80, that is our equation 2. And if I wish to get the value of x, I can multiply equation 1/3 and 2/2, and we subtract the 2. So here we can further write 1 multiplied by 3 - 2 multiplied by 2, and this will result, here y gets cancelled out. The result we are getting is 9x, and this will become +4x = here it is -180, and this is -160, so this is -20. Further simplify, I am getting the value of x as -20/13 volt. So as I've got the value of x, but the value of x is negative, that means this current is flowing from 0 to this negative potential as it flows from high to low potential. So your current through this 4 ohm resistance in magnitude will be 20/13/4. That will be 5/13 ampere. That will be the answer to this problem.